Hi, this is Becky Gromlich from the Watercolor Classroom and Tuesday's Tips. Today we're going to paint this little chickadee for our third week of Christmas cards. I hope you enjoy. I'm going to start with the eye because if you don't get the eye right, you might as well not finish. So I'm going to use Payne's Gray for this eye, and it's pretty light right in the middle where the shine is. So I'm just going to do the whole eye that color and then come in with the darker color around it. And while that dries, I'll go on to the next part of my... This bird has some browns in him, both up here and on the side, and so I'm going to make some browns. I always use quinacridone rust along with ultramarine blue for my browns. And you can get all kinds of shades. That's a brown, and then you can have a somewhat redder brown. I'm going to dry my brush and pull that down because it's got very dark. And I'm making this jaggedy edge along the bottom. And then it goes into a browner color along here. And I think I got that close enough that I don't want the black to run out any further, so I'm gonna push it back. As you can see, I'm switching colors slightly as I move up. And right here, there's actually some little bits of brown. I'm going to dry my brush and lift a little bit of that. It got too dark. It doesn't really have a white outline around that eye, but I'm going to leave the tiniest bit just to have it show a little bit more. I'm adding a touch of purple every now and then to some part of it. So I've put some purple out there. Now before I go on with the eye, I really do need to have, I need it all to be dry around there, or it won't come out looking nice. And I'm gonna get some, just a little tiny bit of pure rust in here. In these little spots, there's just a couple places. bit more Payne's Gray. To blend in here while it's still all wet. Dry my brush. Move upward. The white, I'm gonna leave all of those whites and grays. I'm gonna leave until my paint is a lot drier, all the way dry. This edge is quite soft, and so I'm going to soften that edge and then go on and soften the second edge out there because I'm not sure what I'm going to do with the background. And this edge is also quite soft, and I let that one get a little bit dry, so it'll take a little more agitating to soften. It's more important to have the dark and light, right, than it is to have all those little feathers. When a bird's not close up, you don't see all the little feathers anyhow. But I'm just throwing a little bit of rose in there on my palette with some rust mixed in it for the end of the tail. I kind of like that color in there. Most of that'll get covered and it won't be quite so red looking. I'm gonna have to get some of it off. Okay. Now we're gonna go into some of the grays with perhaps a tinge of blue. And you know, if you don't know if your color is right, you can always make it a little bit. See, that's much grayer than I thought it was. And so I'm going to add a little bit more blue and a little bit of purple. And we have a much less green looking gray. Dry my brush a little bit because it was getting too dark. And down at the bottom it gets quite purplish with some of that pink in here. Just a little bit of pink. Now none of this bird. His chest is totally, totally white. It has little bits of other colors in it. Which is how white usually is. It reflects off of the sky and now out here, it's pretty white. Now these edges, I should have done them maybe while they're wet. You might want to do that if you paint this. So now I'm having to agitate them because that brown and that gray, they came together, come together softly, not harshly like that. I'm even gonna add a little bit more brown to have it blend out into the gray to get that soft, fuzzy look. There we go. And I'm gonna do the same thing with this gray here. Putting it in while it's wet, and I'm getting a soft, fuzzy edge over there. And if I decide to put in some little feathers at the end, I will. But I might not. All right. I am gonna move back to the eye, get my little tiny brush, and put in some Payne's Gray. The little white mark is actually shaped kind of like a check mark. Oops, lost part of the check mark. But he'll just have a different kind of a little sparkle in his eye. Or I'll fix it with bleed-proof white when I'm done. Each of these feathers fades as it moves up. And so I'm gonna wipe off the brush and soften the top edge. This will look a lot less dark when it's, this will look a lot less dark when it's got a darker background. I might not go as dark as that background, but I am planning to put in a little bit of a dark background. That in there, and adding some blues up here as well, in between the browns, or grays rather. So I added some blue in there between those stripes, and then the pink needs to come down into that pink a little bit more. And also blend it in. Well, the beak is kind of gray, blue-gray. I might have to make clean up here and then it kind of disappears as it gets in closer. So I've wet my brush and dried it, and I'm just moving the paint down. And there's a tiny bit of that purple pink color along there, which you don't have to be that fussy with your colors. You know, it's, I'm switching colors a lot, and this bird would look just fine without so much switching. I just like doing it. Yeah, a little bit more dark on the top of this one. Looks a little bit too blue. And I lost the line. That is the dividing part of the beak. Okay, enough on the beak. I'm not happy with this right here, so that'll have to take some tweaking later. But I'm gonna go into these feathers here, which again are this bluish purple color of gray. They're gray. And there's sort of a darker spot right in the middle here. Fuzzy these up a little bit. Just gonna soften that edge till I figure out exactly how I'm gonna do that. I need this part dark back here, because that's what makes the bird look round. I think I actually don't have it dark enough yet. Let's check. right by the tail there. Yeah, it's pretty dark there, almost black. So I'm gonna get some panes of gray into that corner. Not a lot of it. I'll lift that too. And up here. And dry my rinse dry, or dip and dry, not really rinse. And move that down. That has helped a little bit. Let's see if we can get rid of that, because that's supposed to be some little white tail feathers there. Although they're probably gray tail feathers. But I don't want to plop in the middle of them. That'll work. All right, now we're going to put some of the purple blue. Oh, I just got a huge plop of blue. So now I have some purple blue here. It's grayed down a little bit, and then I have this shade. This is dioxazine purple and ultramarine blue. We're gonna get that very watered down. It looks grayer on the paper. So I'm gonna go in and get a little bit of the less gray parts. This has little feathers, things. It's not totally white. I'm going all the way up here. There's some fixing that needs to happen, but I'm gonna get this white before I go back and do anything with those grays. I'm just trying to get the shading in here. I'm not trying to get the little feathers right now. Except for there, I did try. If you get the shading right, then you can always come back and put feathers on with bleed-proof white if you want that much detail. You might not want that much detail. And last but not least, the wing. Gonna soften that edge too. This part's very light, so I'm gonna put some of that color in it, but I want it to be just a touch of it. None of this whole feather wing is white. When that's dry, then I can put the details into that feather, and we'll soften these edges here. So this comes down below his eye, almost to the bottom of his beak, to the middle of his beak. The wing. This whole part is darker. I'm drying my brush off on the sponge a little bit. And then in here, sort of a scalloped edge there. Now there's some browns in that dark part there too, not just grays. I lost some of my whites, but I'll go back and get them later. There's some very darks in here, so that the wing and the bird don't have such a sharp line between them. Right. And down here, there's little bits of yellow, which not as much. It'll mostly get covered. And now we'll get into some greens. I'm going to use sap green. And with the yellows in there, that'll be dark enough for most of it. Actually, I think that was Hooker's green. I'm gonna get some sap green too. So the greens aren't as dark as you would expect. So I have some sap green and Hooker's green, and I'm gonna put some blue out there because down at the base of the pine needles, it gets darker. And probably I'll get Now, these pine needles aren't as dark as you would expect out here, but there are some dark areas in them. And so I've gotten sap green, Hooker's green, ultramarine blue, and Payne's gray on my palette to use for these. And I'm gonna start at the ends with the sap green, but mixed with a little bit of blue because they're all sort of bluer greens. Well, that's not true. Right out at the ends, they're pretty. They're all different colors from each other. It's one of the amazing things about nature. But I am not going to try to have every pine needle exactly shaded because this is a Christmas card and I want to get it done today. So I'm gonna put a lot of dark in here and rinse that and just add some of the lights as I get to the edges. Brings one or two pine needles forward. So you end up with a bunch of different colors of green, which is what it should be. And then in the very base down here, I'll now separate those by having some darker areas. We'll move up to this part. This is the lightest part of the greens. Mixing in with the yellows there. But even those, they aren't as loud as this green appears. So I'm putting the green in, but then I'm gonna go back in with some darker areas. Push back the ones that are behind, like this one. And then of course we need to blend them in with the yellow so that the yellow doesn't look like it's a whole different thing. That would have been probably wiser to do as I went. Shape of that snow there. And when it's drier, I'll go back in. Now these pine needles in the picture, they have a lot of snow on them and are frosty, but I'm just gonna do them green like the other parts. Pine needles. if I was doing a big painting of this and it was going to hang on someone's wall, then I might go to the trouble of doing all of that. These pine needles over here are all darker. The light's not catching them. More blue. Even some Payne's gray at the base. Shadows down here. I'm getting lighter. And then there's places where there's a mound that goes in front of another mound. So there's some shading in those. Just little bits of shadows up here. It's mostly a little bit blue. There's hardly any spots that are just plain white. And that'll all pop out more when the background gets in. this needs some major fixing because of the... So this is a synthetic squirrel, and even though it's a small brush, it holds a lot of water, and I'm gonna make this whole background wet. I'm gonna be really careful around the bird. And I'll probably go into those pine cones individually after I have the rest of the background on, because I don't want them to be compromised. But right now I've just gone over them. They needed to be fuzzied up a little. Is my favorite teal is with phthalo green, which is very bright, and then add purple to it. And then you get this really lovely teal, and you can get it greener or purpler or tealer, depending on how much of which you put. And so there you have a teal. I'm gonna have some purpler areas and some greener areas. I'll probably use some Hooker's green for the greener areas. And this kind of a background that's, you know, all splatchy, all jumbled up like that, it doesn't need bouquet. It looks quite lovely like it is. I don't want a blur around this bird. I mean a white, like a glow around the bird. And down here I'm gonna go with a little bit more purple. Being very careful by its head. I want it to be quite dark around its tail, otherwise the tail is not going to show. But I probably will come back in and get it later. Getting in some more darker color. Now my paper is starting to dry right here, so I just added a drop of water to it so that it wouldn't dry. And this is where I'm gonna get these crispy edges more. I wanna keep having the blue, the greens in there because of the pines, make it look more like a leafy background. Actually, I'm gonna stop way out here. I know that's crazy, because it'll be a little harder to blend in. But I want to get this other part right first. Want some more greens coming here and there. And I actually think I'm gonna make some little pine cone shapes in here. And you need some really thicker green to spread out into the... This is just to give the impression of some pine boughs. and not to make them too long so that they can sort of imitate the one that we have there. Sable, and it has a wonderful point. It doesn't hold as much water and have as much flow. And I'm gonna go with some of the purpler that's down here because it's dark and I want to outline these needles. Make sure that when you put your hand down, you don't get paint everywhere. And a different brush to blend this in to the rest. I think maybe my darker. I want it around this darker part of the body of the bird to be dark enough that the bird pops forward a little bit. And we can always do bleed-proof white and add some we can always do bleed-proof white at the edge here if he doesn't show up enough to add some contrast. Now I liked those pine needles on the wet, and I'm gonna go get some more of them. Oh, this is drier now, so they're not spreading out as much. But I think it's fine. Still giving this idea of pine needles coming in here. So I'll do some of the wetter ones here. And then later, when it's drier, I'll do some of those drier ones. I like those. I want to get a little bit of this dark from up there down here, just a little bit, so that it doesn't look like a different background on this side of the bird. Now the last thing I want to do is to do bleed-proof white, and with that you need a totally clean brush. You really should have totally clean water as well. Mine's a little bit dirty, but I think it'll be okay. And then we'll make a pile of it on here. Well, my brush was a little bit contaminated, so I gotta go in there and fix that now. And this bird is slightly backlit, not a lot. And so we'll water some of the bleed proof down so that it goes on thin and so that some of the color shows through and go back in here. And that's a little bit too thick still. We want it to be, I might even add some color to it. A little bit of the rust. So that helped up there a little bit. And then down here, there's this little layer of whitish pinkish fur. That's sort of the backlit look. And then I'm gonna just soften that edge so that it blends in. actually switching to my Good Clancy Scable. Even though it's a bigger brush, it does have a pointier point for some of these things that I want to add in here. Not quite so dark, though. I keep adding water to the Bleedproof White to make it this faint color. And down here is again that backlit look. Actually, I'm just going to do the wee tiniest bit of snow up here in these branches. Because they certainly would have snow on them too. So I put some grayer snow to give the impression of branches, and then I'm putting some whiter snow to pop forward some branches. We're going to take the tape off. After I take the tape off, I always tweak things. And so you'll see that in the final picture, like I'll finish that. But Bleedproof White takes too long to dry. There you have it. I might decide to put snow, but at this point, I think, I am gonna put snow. I just like snow. So that means I need more Bleedproof White. So my snow is slightly blue. And it needs to be a lot wetter. I'm practicing really hard. I'm getting a bunch of the paint off of it because it was a little bit too wet. I'm just going to dip it in the end. like using a flat brush for snow and holding it up this way. I'm not gonna put any more on that. I think it's enough to give you the idea. And if you like this painting, please hit subscribe and like. Thank you so much for watching.